ALC crew, welcome to week 6, 2021. Here's what's going on this week. Your work, the Roundhouse finale, chapters 10 and 11, journal number 6, and this week's to-do. So let's get started. First, your work. Last week we examined the power of storytelling and how it helps people make sense of their world and overcome trauma, and how Basil's casserole metaphor reflects the instability of the justice system on the reservation. Here's what you had to say.
Gabriella A. wrote, in the novel The Roundhouse by Louise Erdrich, the purpose of storytelling in Ojibwe culture is to give educational messages. These stories give ideas and values, and they also show both positive and negative behaviors. The novel discusses issues such as sexual violence and tribal identities. Rules on the reservation dropped cases if they were against prosecuting natives, which made it hard to bring justice. Lyndon, who was the man who raped Geraldine, was a delinquent who murdered Mela and raped Geraldine. I suppose I'm one of those people who just hate Indians generally. My feelings is that the strong should rule the weak. It is the weak pulling down the strong. This quote by Lyndon is an example of feelings of superiority and negative behavior over Native American cultures and other racial groups, influencing society to hold others down. In life, stories are told to tell people of past experiences, hoping that they can learn something, whether it's something that they should do or avoid doing so they learn from someone else's mistakes. Storytelling can also help people with trauma if they've been through similar situations so they can feel safe and know they're not alone. They can then proceed to take action, get help to fix tough hardships they may be going through, and then help others along the way. Natalie M. wrote, in Chapter 9 of The Roundhouse, Erdrich uses the casserole as a metaphor to portray the instability of the justice system. Joe's father shows Joe how an old casserole is related to the instability of the justice system. In the text, Basil states, that's Indian law. I nodded and looked at the edifice of knives and silverware on top of the sagging casserole. Basil stacks silverware on top of the casserole in a precariously balanced sculpture and tells him it is Indian law. He points to the rotting casserole at the bottom and tells Joe that Indian law is based on the United States stealing native land, a tradition rooted in one old court decision that framed native people as inferior savages. Furthermore, the text states, he pointed to the bottom of the composition and lifted his eyebrows at me. Rotten decisions? Basil demonstrates why he's so committed to the justice system, even though it is often such frustrating, unfruitful work. Basil uses a rotting, half-frozen casserole to represent the case law affecting native sovereignty, reflecting the fact that most of those decisions, as Basil states, were rotten, highly discriminatory, and racist. Basil links all of these to one land control decision, showing how closely linked land is to native oppression.
This week, we move into the climactic finale of The Roundhouse, chapters 10 and 11. A confrontation between Joe, Basil, and Lyndon Lark will foreshadow upcoming violence. Basil's rushed to the hospital after having a heart attack. Joe comes to a grim realization about what he feels he must do to achieve justice. Joe goes to Father Travis for one reason, but Father Travis instead provides him with spiritual guidance. Joe takes matters into his own hands. His community covers up his act of justice. Basil and Joe discuss what justice means and different kinds of justice as Joe wrestles with the moral dilemma of what he has done. Geraldine has come a long way in her healing process, but makes it clear that some scars never heal completely. Tragedy once again marks the finale of the story as Joe loses his best friend, facing the ultimate end of his childhood. Now, our final journal for the Roundhouse. Two options, here they are. Journal number one, justice. Consider Joe's decision to kill Lyndon. The response from his community, the facts we later learn about the case, and Joe's conversations with his father about different forms of justice. What do you think Erdrich is saying about justice? Are there different forms of justice? Is the justice system in America always fair? How do you feel about what Joe did? Journal option number two, healing. The theme for this year's Black History Month program is healing. Let's take this process, healing, and examine it further. What is Erdrich saying about how someone heals? Choose a character from the Roundhouse, Joe, Geraldine, or Basil, and analyze what this character has done to heal from the trauma they encountered. Then connect this idea of healing to our collective experience over the last year. In what ways has our community and our country tried to heal? For both options, make sure to follow these guidelines. One, develop a claim using the XYZ formula that addresses the prompt. Two, integrate two quotes from the text. Three, provide elaboration and your opinion, and four, write 8 to 10 sentences. So what do we have to do? One, read chapters 10 and 11 of The Roundhouse. Two, choose either option one, justice, or option two, healing, for journal number six. And three, extra credit. To earn an additional 5 points, you may share your voice journal entry with our ALC community of learners. When is this due? That's right, the last day of the school week, Friday, February 12th by 11:59 p.m. Next week, we'll further develop our claim evidence warrant writing skills as we develop a review of your choice. That's it for this one, ALC crew. We'll see you in virtual class. In the meantime, stay safe, stay focused, and stay connected.